Hey everybody, it's Stephanie from Elevate Yourself Fitness. I'm sorry that my update has been so long. I've been meaning to update for weeks now and it just keeps slipping my mind because we are actually moving about 6 to 7 hours away. So it's been a really crazy little while here, about 6 weeks it's been since we found out. So since it was about the exact same time that I found out that the transfer worked, we found out that my husband got a job, and so it was when we were wanting this move, but it's still very stressful, a lot going on when you're moving so far away. So that's kind of been occupying my time with house hunting and getting our house ready and all of that, but here I am ready to update you. So far things are going well with the pregnancy. If you're just finding me right now, I am pregnant with an IVF pregnancy and a tested embryo after having a lot of struggles, about 4 years of struggles to start our family due to a fatal genetic condition that my husband and I carry. So our second frozen transfer with IVF worked. So I'm currently 9 weeks, 6 days pregnant. So I will be 10 weeks tomorrow. It seems to be going quite slowly, but I guess on the other hand, it's kind of going fast as well because of all being so busy with the move. I did have an ultrasound yesterday, but before I talk about that one, I just want to go back a little ways. So I found out very, very early that the transfer worked. I had a really early positive test at home. My beta HCG levels were really good at the beginning of the pregnancy. And then when I was 6 weeks pregnant, I actually about 5 weeks, I started having a little bit of dark brown spotting, which was fine. I know that that can be normal. But at 6 weeks, I actually had a lot of really bright red blood and clotting. It was very scary. When it turns bright red, when you start having clotting, it's scary. It can still be normal. So we did go to emergency and we saw a tiny flicker of a heartbeat. So we knew that the baby was still hanging on, but it was a scary time from about 6 to 7 weeks. I was still having some small clots and the bleeding wasn't gone. And then I had an actual ultrasound a couple days later and we saw the baby again and the heart was still beating. So we figured it was just some sort of clot or something, although they couldn't see anything on the ultrasound. And after that, after about 7 weeks, after I passed those clots, I haven't had any more bleeding or issues since. So things have been good. I found the baby's heartbeat on our home Doppler at 7 weeks. 5 days, maybe 6 days, 7 weeks, 6 days pregnant. So before 8 weeks, which was amazing. With all the other babies, I've only found their heartbeats at about 8.5 weeks, which is still really early as well. So that was really good. And that gave me some reassurance, even though for us, a heartbeat does not mean a healthy baby. All of our babies had healthy, had good, healthy heartbeats. But it was the genetic condition, obviously, that was fatal. So I had the ultrasound yesterday at 9 weeks, 5 days. And here is, let's see which picture I show you here. Here is the baby looking more like a baby than I expected. That's baby's head and that's his or her hand right there. So it is still early, not even 10 weeks. So they can't do any actual measurements of limbs or anything like that, which is what, we need to confirm the testing. Now, as I said, this is a tested embryo. This baby has been tested for short-rib polydactyly syndrome, which is the gene we carry, as well as chromosomes, and it was healthy. So it should not have any of those things, but unfortunately the testing is not 100%, so there is still a chance in. I'm still terrified of something going wrong, obviously, after all we've been through. So far, so good. I will have another ultrasound in a couple weeks when I'm 12 weeks pregnant, and hopefully the limbs will measure nice and long. We've never had that on any of our 12-week ultrasounds. So we're really hoping that the measurements are good. The clinic and the PGD lab really want us to have a CVS test done, but my doctors My high-risk doctors are saying we've been through too much, that this embryo should be healthy to not risk doing a CVS. So we're a little torn on whether or not I'll be doing a CVS at 12 weeks or not. As of now, the plan is, I think is going to be to do the ultrasound at 12 weeks, do the measurements, and if we have any questions, if we have any inkling that something is wrong or that the baby is affected, then we will do the CVS. But if everything is measuring really well, then I think we'll forego it. We can always do an amnio later on, closer to 16 weeks, if something changes in that time. But I, at this point, don't know if I want to risk a healthy pregnancy to have the testing when this embryo should be healthy. But on the other hand, I want that reassurance as well. So still a little bit torn, but I think we'll just play it by ear, see what the ultrasound shows. If it's really good, we'll probably just hold out and, you know, keep going every couple weeks and make sure that the baby is still growing and that the limbs are still growing, right? So that we know that the baby is not affected with our fatal condition. So that is my update. We're moving in a couple days. We're just renting, so we're not full on moving right now until we get a house and until our house sells. So we're just packing some stuff, but not everything, but it's still kind of a stressful time. So hopefully everything continues to go well, and I will be sure to update you again soon. So probably in about 2 weeks when I have my 12-week ultrasound, I promise I will come on and update you. So thank you all so much for following me, for all the messages, and for everyone asking for updates. Like I said, I'm so sorry it took so long, but I got it done now and all is good. I am more active lately on Facebook. So if you want to follow me over on Facebook, you will probably see updates a little bit more often. As I am a health and fitness coach and I am working out throughout this pregnancy. I wasn't as I was bleeding, but I just started working out again. And so I will be sharing my journey a lot on my Facebook page as well, if you want to come follow me there. So thanks again, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye guys.